ഇപ്പോൾ പ്രകാശ് കാരാട്ട് വാർത്താ സമ്മേളനം നടത്തുന്നു.
If any amendments have to be pressed on the basis of the report we placed, there will be amendments can be put to vote if necessary. And then the entire resolution will be put to vote and adopted. Already we had one round of pre-Congress amendments. That process is over and that report had been placed before the discussion started on the draft political resolution. But delegates have the right to move amendments after taking understanding what are the pre-Congress amendments which have been accepted. I think that's already informed to you that we accepted about 363 amendments. I can't give you the exact number of amendments we have received from delegates now because that is still being processed. I am halfway through that work before I came here. But as usual, there'll be a couple of hundred amendments. I don't know exact number. We would be able to tell you that in an hour or so. The discussion has been very good in the sense that given the fact that our country is facing a very difficult situation under the Modi government, how to meet the situation, how to fight against this government, how to rally all the democratic and secular forces to ensure the defeat of this government. Naturally, this is a matter which is of intense interest to our delegates. So we have been very much benefited by the discussion, and we are confident that by late evening today, the political resolution will be adopted, which is the main agenda of this party Congress. Since this press conference is being held at an awkward time, because we have to now go forward to the reply and adoption. So I'm not able to tell you much more because that process is on, and it will not be fair on the party Congress for me to give you any the main content or direction of the resolution, because that will be now the delegates who will give the final seal of approval. So I cannot get into the nitty-gritties of the resolution. The second agenda will be taken up tomorrow morning, which is the political organizational report. That is a review of the work we have done in the previous 3 years, the political aspect and the organizational aspect. Of course, the main focus will be on the organization, how we have implemented the organizational direction and task set out for us at the organizational plenum that we held in Kolkata in December 2015. So that will be the second main agenda we will take up. In the meantime, a number of resolutions have been adopted yesterday evening and in this morning session. I'll just like to highlight two of them. One is, we have adopted a resolution on the terms of reference of the 15th Finance Commission. About the Finance Commission. As you may be aware, already there is a lot of criticism about the terms of reference which the government has framed for the Finance Commission. Recently, there was a meeting in Trivandrum of Chief Finance Ministers of Southern States, who have prepared a note for the Finance Commission stating their objections to the terms of reference. I don't want to go into the details, but this Finance Commission has been given terms of reference which, according to us, is an assault on the federal principle. Finance Commission is a constitutionally ordained body which decides on the division of the resources between the center and the states. But extraneous elements have been brought into the terms of reference by the central government. Apart from the population criteria, which was earlier 1971, now it is shifted to 2001 census, which means that states which have taken steps to control the population and who have made advance in bringing down the birth rate, they are going to suffer in terms of financial resources being devolved. 1971 was taken as the point of reference because that's when the national population policy was formulated and the states were expected to implement it. So the states have performed well in this respect are going to be suffering. That is why most of the southern states are upset about it. But it's not only that, the terms of reference have also included, as I said, extraneous factors like to discourage populist measures or policies. Now, it's not the business of a commission like the Finance Commission to decide what are populist policies. That's for the elected representatives and the elected governments to decide. So they want to discourage populist policies. This is, I think, an ideologically loaded intervention as far as the terms of reference are concerned.
രാഷ്ട്രീയ പ്രമേയത്തിന്മേലുള്ള ചർച്ച പൂർത്തിയായി. രഹസ്യ വോട്ടെടുപ്പ് വേണമെന്ന് കൂടുതൽ സംസ്ഥാനങ്ങൾ ആവശ്യപ്പെടുന്നു. അതേസമയം വോട്ടെടുപ്പ് സാധ്യത തള്ളാതെ പ്രകാശ് കാരാട്ടും രംഗത്തെത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നു. വാർത്താസമ്മേളനം നടത്തുകയായിരുന്നു അദ്ദേഹം.